most people end up living lives of what I like to call quiet desperation, and they are pretty much slaves to their 9-to-5, the preconceived notions of how one should actually go about making money or building a business. And in my opinion, these are all mechanisms of control to subdue society and control society at mass scale.
What do you say to people who say that you're just talking shit?
I get people that say that I'm talking out of my ass, but who cares?
It's like many things, like if people actually sit down and listen to you on long form content, you make a lot of sense. You're very articulate, very intelligent. But if somebody sees the short form chopped up clip of you saying something for 30 seconds out of context.
The treatment that people with money, influence, and power have when shit hits the fan
is
completely different than the average person that is stocking shelves and that is just utilized as an expenditure.
Well, that's why I'm all for space exploration. Like, I do think that it's important for our species to be interplanetary and not be stuck just to this one planet.
I mean, now with this whole weather control thing, the time could come where you can basically cloud seed and create civilization on other places.
Have you heard that the HEART program, which I think is, I don't know if that's associated with America, but apparently it's something to do with how they can alter the atmosphere to affect weather systems.
But
that's all very secretive. Nobody really knows how
you can look at that. You can look at Bill Gates, who's a massive crook, and he's now pushing something to add haze into the atmosphere to start kind of covering the sun so that it doesn't cause the planet to warm up. I'm like, okay, so yeah, this guy's just playing God now.
It's gonna be no side effects of that.
Yeah.
Do you think there's anybody who is in a very strong position of influence who's actually doing a good job? Like someone you admire who's like, okay, yeah, he's doing a good job. Like he's actually trying to make a positive difference to the world.
It's a tough one because all you can go off of is perception, and perception is controlled, right? So whether you're an influencer that's a small one or a big one, whatever content you put out ends up being how people perceive you. So what if the people that run the world understand how to control that narrative? Anybody that's in a government institution, I just automatically don't trust them, because I don't truly think that we need big government the way that it's being pushed on us. I don't believe in this source of controlled authority over mass amounts of people. And the ones that are like, oh, well, Luke's talking out of his ass, or Luke doesn't understand that you do need government. Well, you've never lived in a situation whereby you've actually had deep levels of freedom. When I tell people, let's say you were a society that was in slavery, and let's say you're born in year 200 of that 400 year cycle of slavery, you have no concept of freedom. You have no concept whatsoever of what it means to be autonomous. Today, we look at the US dollar built on the fiat system, a massive way to control society by printing money out of thin air and getting people employed. That's why they're called human resources, right? Because you're just an expendable resource for creating, building all these things that are pretty much propped off of debt and off of fiat. It's pretty much slavery, right? And yeah, certain people can get out of it. Certain people can, you know, finesse their way to the top. And like I said, the internet kind of has given people the opportunity to do that. But most people end up living lives of what I like to call quiet desperation, and they are pretty much slaves to their 9-to-5. They're slaves to the preconceived notions of how one should actually go about making money or building a business. And in my opinion, these are all mechanisms of control to subdue society and control society at mass scale. Keep people broke. In the US, for example, everything's on credit and everything's on debt. Oh, you want to get a house? Okay, perfect. Get a mortgage. Mortgage is a loan. Oh, you want to get a car? Perfect. Here's a car payment. They sell iPhones on payment plans. Everything's on a payment plan. That's all debt. It's all propped up by something that's not real. What's a 30-year mortgage? Imagine getting a 30-year mortgage at the age of 60. What are you going to pay it off when you're 90? It's not real. It's bullshit. So in the 40s and the 50s, when people were working at factories before the dollar was hijacked by the Federal Reserve and removed off of the gold standard, you would work 2, 3, 4, 5 years in a factory, make your $2,000, $3,000, $4,000, $5,000 a year. And in 2 years, you would buy a house. You would buy a car. You wouldn't have to work 10 years in order to afford a place to live. And that all comes down to the fact that the money printers are the way to steal from people through inflation and through the debasement of currency, which is why what we're seeing nowadays, like I said, unless you understand monetary policy, unless you understand that finance is the new language of the elite, just like back in the day, Latin used to be the language that the church would utilize to control the peasants. Instead of teaching the peasants Latin, or in this case, the peasants nowadays finance, you would have the Pope, or you would have the minister be the one that was the middleman between you and God. And that's why when you look at the US dollar, it says, "In God we trust." It's really funny, because you're not trusting in your own ability to decipher what's taking place, you're going off of a middleman. If you look at the tax code, it's 4,000, 5,000, 6,000 pages long. Who has time to read that? Who has time to actually understand what's taking place, or if what we're being taxed is legitimate or fair or constitutional or even legal? They don't. So people nowadays are really much trusting off of big organizations, and anything that has an acronym as an organization, whether it starts with an F or whether it starts with a C, all these crazy ones that I'm not going to say just in case we end up being in a bad situation, you need to be very skeptical. Because you don't know who's behind it. And these centralized sources of authority, whether they start off legitimate, which they truly could, can end up being in a situation that they can get hijacked and compromised. Just like these big social media platforms, they get hijacked from the inside. If you look at Pavel's interview with Tucker Carlson the other day, he talks about how a big government agency, I think it was the FBI, when he went to set up his headquarters in San Francisco, they approached one of his developers to inside of the Telegram code to put back doors so that they could get spied on. But this all happened on different social media platforms. So imagine you have all these backdoors already set up ahead of time. You hijack developers, insert ghost code, and start managing mass surveillance at a level that hasn't been seen before. It was a it was pretty much introduced in the United States in 2001 after 9/11. It's called the Patriot Act. And it's really such a funny name because they always make it sound super epic, but it's basically a massive surveillance program to control populations. It's very scary. So going back to your initial question, is there any big influencers or influential people at a political scale that I would trust? The answer is no. Because if you're playing in the swamp and you're playing the dirty game, it's going to be a hard one.
What do you think of Elon Musk?
Elon is an interesting character. I think he understands psychology and understands persuasion and understands human nature better than most. I think he's doing a lot of net positive things, but simultaneously, you have to be skeptical at somebody who's utilizing cobalt mines in the middle of Africa, right, in order to power Tesla batteries, and utilizing, you know, children and teenagers and women to get this out of the ground. You also have to look at, for example, Tesla. Tesla is pretty much a surveillance vehicle at this point, powered by electricity, which could be turned off at any moment. In fact, in China right now, going back to China, if you have a poor social credit score, you can't charge your Tesla, right? Which is crazy. What happens when that gets introduced in the West and everybody has an electric vehicle? So they'll tell you on one
side.
Do you
think that's why they're pushing electric vehicles
100%,
so much?
Yeah. Because it's a mechanism of control. You have one kill switch and you can basically turn off all sorts of travel. Think about it. Hey, regulation says you can't leave 5 kilometers from your house, new pandemic, new virus. Oh, well, you don't want to comply? Well, we're tracking through your car. Your car has Wi-Fi. You went 5 kilometers outside of your house. Turn off car. Boom. And it doesn't even have to come down specifically to one individual like Elon. But this entire premise right now of biometric scans to access the internet is getting pretty dangerous. So I think there's also a net positive, but he really knows how to play people and play both sides of the aisle.
He's always a few steps ahead. He's good.
He's good. He's very good. And that's why he is where he is today.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, like I said, I don't trust a lot of people in these high ranks. And that's probably why I haven't been invited to any of these crazy parties.
I like what he's doing, trying to get people on Mars, though. I think we should be pushing space exploration more. Like, all that kind of stuff is so fascinating.
It's fascinating.
Like, I love to know the origins of where we came from, humanity, the universe, things like that. Do you have any strong thoughts on that?
Bro, I'm just here today, right now. I spawned into this reality, this three-dimensional realm. I don't know what the fuck is happening. Some people tell you that there's reptilians. Some people tell you that there's all sorts of shit. All I know is that there's something weird, right, taking place. I can't put my finger on it. I don't know what exactly it is. All I know is that humanity is very much controlled at a mass scale, and it's definitely controlled by maybe a couple thousand people that really understand how the world really works. And they do it through banking. They do it through social media platforms, and they are being quite effective at it.
What do you say to people who say that you're just talking shit and you're crazy?
I mean, that's fine. That's fine.
Do you get
that's,
a lot
that's,
of that?
That's, yeah, I get it every now and then. I get people that say that I'm talking out of my ass, but who cares?
But I think it's like many things. Like, if people actually sit down and listen to you on long form content, like an hour and a half, like, you make a lot of sense. You're very articulate, very intelligent. But if somebody sees the short form chopped up clip of you saying something for 30 seconds out of context, people are like, what the where's this coming from?
What's for sure. And I think that's the beauty of short form. Short form isn't about expressing your full opinions. Short form is basically just like an internet billboard. So the more billboards you have, the more views you get and the more eyeballs you get. And then Long form content is where people actually get to understand and know what you're actually about.